Welcome to my YouTube channel, Divine Empowerment. Today is a very special day because it's my birthday. I am so excited. And I just, even though my website isn't completely ready and I'm getting into that launching phase and all that kind of good stuff, I just felt like I needed to share today with you guys, at least a little bit. I'll be doing lots of videos. I'm also going to be taking some reading sessions and hopefully get you guys into the Akashic record clearings. Should be really exciting. Now, my first video, I really want to, because it's my birthday and because it's so close and dear to my heart, which I hope the audio turns out on this. If it doesn't, please forgive me. So, what's near and dear to my heart? The twin flame. Divine partnership. Yeah, I mean, there's so much to share, right? With all these great energies coming in, especially yesterday, Mother's Day. Oh, wow. Huge solar flare. And it's just, it feels good, too, to not be triggered by them anymore. If you guys are still getting triggered by these solar flares, I am so sorry. Like, for real, so sorry. It has been a very trying integration period, if you know what I mean. So, I've already pulled some cards and said some prayers and everything. I will post my email below, so please like, subscribe, share. Much gratitude. So, let's get started. The first thing that we're going to talk about is the Divine Masculine's energy and where he's at right now and what's going on over there. So, now I don't do readings like in the traditional sense. I mainly tap in. The cards are here to kind of guide the channeling that happens. So, yeah, so just bear with me. Some cards I'll be showing, some I won't. So where is the masculine? You know, he's been going through a lot. A whole lot. Like, you know, he's been in his head and been in his heart. And for you divine feminines, like when you're around your divine masculine, pay close attention to their eye color, their voice, the tone of their voice. It'll change. You can tell when they're speaking from their head or speaking from the heart. But I think that they're really, you know, going through that whole, you know, what should I do? What should I do? You know. And they're really starting to, you know, the heart of the sky. They're really getting their intuition now, and they're starting to have more and more dreams. But it's also causing them to kind of like step into a position of, or I should say them, no, I mean their ego, steps into a position of authority. Like, sometimes when, and this happens in every twin flame journey, you always have one twin that's more awakened than the others. Than the other one. So basically, it's about what energy your soul is primarily. In my specific journey, I would be classified like a divine masculine. And what that means for me is that I'm more connected to divine than I am to earth, Mother Earth. So, you know, intuition, channeling, you know, divine source, angels, all of that seems normal to me. Now, Earth, coming down here where you actually have to wait for things to show up and you have to be patient. And
grounded, structured.
Yeah, not so much. However, through this integration period, I have been able to find some balance. The two energies,
which I'm super excited about, and I think that's
what really got me on here doing this video.
So again, it's about, you know, them getting out of the way of their ego. Now we all do this,
you know, and the ego is the master at keeping us where we are. And it just takes continued effort. And also too, I mean, there's a lot of tools that can help you. Dowsing with pendulums, excellent way to connect with your guidance.
Connect with your higher self. And
yeah, I mean, that's probably one of my favorite ways. Now cards too, they help you connect, and
it's almost like
you're sneaking around your ego a little bit. It's not really deception, but you know, it's allowing you to connect in a way that
doesn't
have you going into a panic attack
or shutting down or freezing up. So let me continue on here. And I'm so sorry about the air conditioning. I live in Southeast Texas, okay? So yeah, it's always a must. Now, you know, he's been in this hermit mode. And what's so interesting to me is that he knows this connection is divine. He knows just as much as you know. And again, depending on which energy your soul resonates with, you know, so you can douse for that information. It's a great way to find out, to figure out exactly what you need to come into balance and integration. And I encourage everyone, please, please, please connect with your guidance team, because they're there. They're waiting for you. Just ask. Say, hi, I need some help.
So anyway, back to the masculine energy.
You know, recently I went through some really weird stuff, which, I don't know. I probably won't go into that today because it's my birthday, yay. And, but, you know, I don't know how many of you out there are working with your shadow self, or maybe you're thinking about working with your shadow self. And if
this journey is not for
the faint-hearted, you know, it takes severe devotion, severe dedication. I mean, it requires you to really, really own who you are, to be your authentic self. And that's what I love about it the most. I mean, because without it, I don't know that I would have been able to step into
who I really am. And moving forward with
the divine energy here, I know I'm a little nervous. It's my first video.
Please forgive me. So,
they've been in this hermit mode, you know, contemplating, battling between their heart and their ego. And they're a little bit upside down.
You know, you've got the Knight of Wands. They want success. They just don't really know how
or what that looks like yet.
And they also know
that the
world
is ready for this. We have actually anchored in the
new zero point
at Bliss. Yay! That was exciting. That happened here in my area specifically on April 18th of this year. And
things
have just really gone well with that. And it's available for everyone. I don't know if you may feel called to do your own anchoring.
And then again,
as a collective, there are anchors available around the world. So just find one that resonates with you, a timeline that resonates with you, and meditate on it. You know, request, ask, you know, you shall receive. Ultimately, in the twin flame journey,
I know, Ten of Cups. Aww, and I love these cards.
Oh my goodness, I'm gonna see if I'll The lilies and the water and yeah, beautiful. Tinnakets. Also too, guys, I have papillons, so you might hear them in the background from time to time.
Now, as I'm laying these
cards out, I will start channeling some messages from the divine masculine to the divine female, to the divine feminine. And I mean, twin flames, divine partnerships, sacred unions, ascension. Because guess what? You don't have to be in a relationship to go through this journey, okay? Just know that. It's about finding balance within so that you can create and manifest the reality that you desire.
Okay.
Now, if you have been in a divine partnership or you've met your twin flame, so to speak, it can be very exhausting at times, you know. And the masculine energy, I mean, he's just wore out. I mean, just smooth worn out. Like, support. It's time to be carried. Allow others to help. And it's important because when you're in separation, which I don't even like that word, but we'll just say when you're in your
timeouts,
it can be very lonely, you know? And all you have to remember is that there are so many other people, so many other beings, whether it's pets, animals, that are here loving you continuously. And you're never really separated from your divine partner. And a big part of that, you know, not being too lonely, you know, making a connection of any kind, whether it's through visiting a nursing home, keeping someone's child, you know, touch, exchange some sort of energy, connection. I know that in my divine partnership, my masculine, he's had a really hard time how I exchange and how I connect with people in general. But I think he's starting to finally maybe see that it's pure, it's innocent. Our love is pure and innocent. And our love for each other is pure and innocent. So, you know, when you get too weary on the journey and you just feel like you just need to take a break, divine masculines, hey, go out, you know, get a hug, exchange some conversation, you know, make a connection. And a big, oh well, yeah, so the divine masculine wants the divine feminines to know that hold on, hold on. I just need you to hold on. Be strong, stand your ground. Yeah, most definitely stand your ground. And sure enough, I mean, oh wow. Unrequited love. You know, just when you feel like things, like it's just not going to work out or it's not going to happen, guess what? You have to trust. The situation is calling for you to have faith. And so, whenever he's saying, hold on, I'm not here. It feels like I'm not with you, that I'm not loving you. But I am. Hold on. Be strong. Trust. And this just seems to be a really recurring theme. Trust, trust, bottom of the deck. Overall theme of the reading for the collective is trust. Trust. And believe, you know, connect with your divine partner in 5D or 3D, whichever, you know, reconciliation. Someone from your past is returning to your life. Which, you know, I don't really necessarily like that sentence because that's not representative of what he wants to say. What he wants to say is, reconcile within, reconcile yourself, and hold on. Stand your ground.